Chop chop, top of the morning, Modern King Boxing, back with another one, Boxer's Motto, etc. This week, Saturday, we have a fight between Canelo Alvarez and Jamie Munguia. Will Munguia pull off the upset over an aging Canelo Alvarez, or will Canelo show him that there's levels to this? Let's get it right after this intro. Canelo versus Munguia tonight. But in other news, Devin Haney has redeemed himself, and the fans of Devin Haney have redeemed themselves because Ryan Garcia popped dirty. We're waiting for the B sample to come back. Usually when the A sample is dirty, the B sample will be dirty. Ryan Garcia contested it, and that is that news right there in itself. Ryan Garcia seems to be very combative, or confidence, if you want to call it, that he will be victorious in the B sample, or he thinks that is a conspiracy against him. Well, Clarissa Shields is in the news again. Javante Tank Davis had a few choice words, so Clarissa Shields clapped back like the goat she is, and she told him that he was basically jealous of Devin Haney, and she basically went on a good rant, and she basically called him out and said that, you know, he just hates Devin Haney. And of course, Javante Tank Davis, with his dumb self, got ignorant with her and basically called him every choice. He called her every choice word in the book other than queen. You feel me? The WBO president has said that Crawford is their super champion and that they will make sure that he is next in line if anything happens at 154. And here we go. The fight. This is a good fight right here on Javante Tank Davis' card. It would be David Benavidez against that guy from the Ukrainian. He basically is up for the challenge. David Benavidez is moving up. This is a very good matchup with David Benavidez moving up. This guy has been out for a while. He's fighting the Ukrainian, and he's basically challenging to go up to 175 and be successful, David Benavidez. Now on to the main topic on Boxer's Motto, etc. Javante the Cabbage Patch Kid Davis has turned into a gremlin on stage. He basically was saying that, yeah, I stay in the house because I am the tweet king, because, you know, Frank Martin said that all you do is tweet. So then, you know, Javante Davis basically got real ignorant. You know, he said he's the streets. You just a dude from the suburbs. You know how Javante Dick Davis is. Thug life. You know, don't nobody touch me. Everybody stay away from me when I'm talking. You know how he is. He's just real ignorant. Ignorance is bliss with Javante Tank Davis, and his fans love it. They enjoy the moxie that comes out of his mouth. That's all ignorant moxie. Never good moxie. But yeah, he's a great boxer. You know, Javante Tank Davis, you know, showed, at one point he showed Frank Martin some footage of when, you know, they was, when Frank Martin was clinching him and sparring back in the day. You know, Javante always got them receipts of sparring. You know, Frank Martin was like, you know, that wasn't me then. That wasn't me then. It ain't gonna be me now. So, you know, here we go. You know, Javante Tank Davis and him got into it on the stage a little bit. You know, even though Javante Tank Davis said he didn't want nobody to hold him back, you know, it came to a point where Frank Martin put his hand up and Javante Tank Davis showed his speed. This dude has real speed. I mean, my phone was glitching. He's so fast. So, yeah, you know, it's true about, you know, the skill level of Javante Tank Davis because he's so short and compact to the ground. Frank Martin, you know, tried to thwart it off, but it was definitely something that was noticeable that he was visibly slower than Tank Davis. And there you have it. Boxers, models, etc. all wrapped up in the one. You know, fuck this. Everybody.